The next thing I want to talk about is distributing things evenly on the page, maybe spacing these out evenly. And a flowchart's not really a good example for this. So I've created another example. And I'll put this out on the web page if you want to download it and play with it. So I want these blue objects. I want to evenly distribute the space in between these objects. The way to do that is to select all our objects. And then right-click when I'm over an object. If I don't have that four-sided arrow, this won't work. And that won't work when I'm in any group. You need to be over the object to get that four-sided arrow to bring up our shortcut menu. And then I want to use this distribution. And you'll notice this doesn't appear if you right-click on a single object. You need to have a group of objects. When I click distribution, it brings up this dialog box. And it says left, center, spacing, and right. We're dealing only with the horizontal. The vertical works the same way. So once you understand the horizontal, you'll understand the vertical. So I want to evenly space these out from the left. Clicking OK. So I've got this box here that I'm going to move up and show that from the left side of the first object to the left side of the second object is the width of this box. And moving this over, we see from the second object to the third object is the width of the box. And again, same thing. And the last one, now it might be off by a pixel or two because it has to take the best fit, but for the most part, it's the same size as this box. So we can see that the left means the left side of the one object to the left side of the object next to it. Selecting them again. Going into distribution, this time we want to go center. And we can see that the center is a different size than the left. So if I go to the center of the object on the left to the second object in, and we see that the centers match up again. And again, so it doesn't matter on the shape, it just fits them in as best we can. Now we're going to select the group again and select spacing. This is the one I intended when I meant space evenly. I want even space in between all my objects. So I bring it up and we see this space from the right side of the first object to the left side of the second object. Move it over to the right side of the second object to the left side of the third object. And so on and so on. And then doing it again for the right. We see the right side of the first object to the right side of the second. And again. Again, and the triangle, the circle to the triangle. So we can see how that works. Although when you look at it without those boxes, you're wondering how this is spaced evenly. Now we know. I've got one more comment about this example. If you're moving things around and then you want to realign them, don't move the two outside shapes. If you move them, then these boxes won't line up. If you notice, when we line things up, I select them all, distribution, and it lines them up to the two edges. So I'm going to space them evenly, and it spaces them to the two outside edges. So if you move the right or the left edge, it will adjust all of these, and these boxes will no longer fit on the left. I mean, you'll have to resize them, and then the left will match up to the left. Once you measure one, the rest will all measure up. But if you move the outside edges, you will have to adjust your box size. I'm going to select them one more time and center them horizontally. And that's how to distribute shapes in LibreOffice Draw.